Consciously use the word had because I hope that a change has come in and this change is just going to go on. Something has been ailing legal education in our country. The Radha Krishnan Committee, in its report on university education, lamented, I quote, "Our law colleges do not hold a place of high esteem, either at home or abroad, nor has law become an area of profound scholarship and enlightened research." The Law Commission of India, in its 14th report, the report is also commonly referred to as the Setalwa Commission report of 1958, to quote from the report, "The system of education, legal education is defective because it fails to organize the study of law as a branch of science." And was a plethora of LLBs, half-baked lawyers, who do not even know the elements of the law, who are let loose upon society as drones and parasites in different parts of the country. Most unfortunate, because I have also done my LLB in this country, in a law college. It was the Calcutta University College of Law. I have practiced as an advocate in this country, and comments like this can be really very hurtful. But even today, perhaps, there are many lawyers who still fail to achieve the requisite standards, as a result of which the Bar Council of India, in collaboration with the state bar councils, are trying to devise ways and means to improve legal education and ensure that the members of the legal profession who are referred to as the learned lawyers, the learned advocates, are truly learned. These law institutions do not only lay the foundation of lawyers and maybe judges, but also academicians, researchers, who mold the shape of the law, which we can discuss a little later. In our country, we have a written constitution. The constitutional principle, perhaps our constitution, is one of the best. It contains certain principles, it contains ideals. These ideals are summarized in the preamble of the Constitution. It is justice. To some, justice means meeting out that which is just. To some, it means that which is right. Securing for a person that which is rightfully due to a person. Now, an example of justice. Let us say the father has a loaf of bread and he has to divide it amongst his three children. How is he going to do it? One view may be complete equality, divide it equally between the three children. But a question may arise. One may be older, the other may be a child. So the needs of the elder child may be a little more. So the elder child may claim a bigger loaf of the bread because his needs are greater. The second child may say, no.
தொடர்ந்து இது போல வீடியோஸ் பார்க்கறதுக்கு கீழே இருக்க சப்ஸ்கிரைப் பட்டனை கிளிக் பண்ணுங்க.